Hello everyone, today we'll be starting the second chapter. We completed the motion in a straight line. Now today we'll be doing motion in a plane. Now this chapter was completed. This we jump in the second part of kinematics. Okay, in motion in a plane, most of the part of motion in a plane is vectors. So I have given the explanation in vectors, so please go and watch this lecture first if you are going to start with this chapter. Okay, and after vectors we have relative motion, we have projectile motion. Okay, after projectile motion, when we are done with projectile motion, then we will be done with the mechanics one part, which is kinematics. Okay, so now we'll be starting relative motion. Now what is relative motion? Relative motion is defined as the calculation of the motion of an object with regard to some other moving or static object. Thus the motion is not calculated with reference to Earth, but is the velocity in reference to the other moving object as if it were in a static state. Okay, object moving in respect of an observer to relate things. So here we'll be taking two bodies. Okay, we'll be taking two bodies and we will be seeing that this is moving with 2 meters per second and this is moving with 4 meters per second. Now what will be the variable velocity? Hum log do object ko pakde hai. Ek object hai A and ek object hai B. And ek object, well, ek velocity se daud raha hai jo hai 2 meters per second aur ek aur move kar raha hai which is of 4 meters per second. Theek hai? Now, we will be seeing what is the relative velocity. We have some terms in relative motion. We have some terms. Now, there are some terms of relative motion. So here they are the terms. The relative velocity of A with respect to B. This is with respect to B. Matlab, relative velocity hai jo body A with respect to B है और ये है VAB equal to VA plus minus VB. VAB is equal to VA plus minus AB. I'll be discussing why I have written plus minus here. Okay, so the velocity of the body A is VA, the velocity of body V is VB. Here we'll be taking that what is the relative velocity here, relative velocity. ठीक है, so we will be taking one body at rest. To make the question problem easy, we'll take one body at rest. Okay, so taking one body at rest, we have velocity of A is 2 meters per second, velocity of B we have 4 meters per second. Okay, so we'll be seeing that VA plus VB is equal to VAB minus VB equal to 2 minus 4 equal to 2 meter per second. So here the A will be seeing, A ko aisa lagega ki body B 2 meter per second iske away ja raha hai. The body A is moving 2 meter per second away from A. Okay, now we'll be discussing some more thing, that when relative velocity is in one axis, okay, when the body is moving in one axis, the body two axes mein nahi jaake bas ek axis mein, like the body A or body B, ye dono ek axis mein move kar rahe, then we'll be taking jo summation subtraction hoga, all will be in algebraic form. Look here, the when it is in one axis, then summation and addition of velocities are in algebraic form. And when we have two axes, okay, suppose this is vector A, this is vector B, okay, then the resultant will be the relative velocity. Okay, then the addition and subtraction will be in vector form. Okay, in the vector rules, the way we add and subtract, like if it's addition, then we'll be saying A square plus B square minus 2AB cos theta. Okay, when it is subtraction, when it is addition, then we will be saying a square plus b square, okay, plus 2ab cos theta. Now these things are all, everything is discussed in the in vector, okay, so you can go and see there. So this will be the resultant and this will be the relative velocity, the resultant of these two vectors. Okay, now y positive and y negative. Y negative and when negative in relative velocity, when the two bodies are moving in same direction, then velocity of two bodies are subtracted and thus it is VAB equal to VA minus VB. Like here I say the body A is moving and the body B is moving. We will simply take one body at rest. Okay, so here after taking rest, we'll see that the body B is moving 10 meter per second away from A. Okay, here A is moving away from B. B is moving away from A, and it is moving with 10 meter per second. The relative velocity will be 10 meter per second. So A will be assuming that the body B is moving 10 meters away from him, and when it is positive, then like y positive and when positive, when the two bodies are moving in opposite direction, then velocities of two bodies are added up. Okay, like there are two bodies which are coming to each other, then we add up the relative velocity. Okay, velocity gets add up. Now comes some questions. Okay, I just repeat my points once again. When there are body A and body B, when they are moving in same direction, okay, when they are moving in same direction, we will be subtracting their velocities. When body is in different direction or in opposite direction, we will be adding up. Okay, and now it's something is same here, like we say relative velocity. Okay, same is with relative acceleration. Here in acceleration we say AB equals to acceleration of body A plus acceleration of body B. Okay, and when we need to subtract, then acceleration of body A minus acceleration of body B. So in relative, when we will be solving the problems of relative motion, we need to make sure that the velocity and the acceleration should be this and not the velocity of the body. Okay, we won't be taking this velocity, but we'll be taking this velocity and we'll be taking this acceleration when it is relative motion problems. Okay, we need to take out the relative velocity, we need to take out the relative acceleration. Please be very careful when it's about direction. Okay, when it's direction, always it is not there that VAB is plus or it is minus or plus. Okay, please be very careful with the directions. Now we come to the problem. Two bodies are moving in velocity 5 meter per second and 2 meter per second, different directions, and going to collide or meet each other. Take out the time taken if displacement between them is 21 meter. Now you will be seeing that in the question there is given different directions. Please see here, different direction, and we have been discussing when it's a different direction, then the velocity gets added up. Okay, so now I always say that we need to take the relative velocity when it's a relative motion problem. So the relative velocity is VA plus VB. When it's opposite direction or different direction, we will be adding up the velocities. Okay, and here we take out the relative velocity, VA plus VB is 5 plus 2 equal to 7 meter per second. So what we need to calculate is the time taken. Here we made a diagram. If you will solve the problems by making diagrams, then it will be really very easy for you. Bahut easy ho jata hai question when we make the diagram, when we think what is happening and what is not happening. So 21 meter is the distance displacement between them, and when they'll meet, okay, at this point they'll be meeting. So what will be the t? Velocity is displacement into time. Time is displacement by velocity. So this is relative velocity, okay? Relative velocity. 21 by 7, it is 3 seconds. So at 3 seconds, these two will be meeting or they'll be colliding. Okay, we have different problems of relative motion. We'll be discussing it. So now the next question is, two bodies are moving in velocity 5 meter per second and 2 meter per second in same directions, and take out the time taken when they will meet each other, or when one will cross one, okay, when A will cross B. Okay, displacement is 21 meter. Now you will be seeing that I just changed the question by directions only. Everything is same, everything, only the direction has been changed. Okay, I gave different directions, so different direction, the variable, the relative velocity will get add up. When it's same direction, the relative velocity gets subtracted. Okay, so here we again made the diagram. Okay, so the relative velocity, first we'll be taking out the relative velocity. The velocity of A is 5 meter and the velocity of B is 2 meter per second. So we get the relative velocity 3 meter per second, and the time taken was displacement. Okay, the displacement 21 meter, displacement by variable velocity, okay, which is 7 seconds. So at 7 seconds, A will cross over B. Okay, cross over B. Okay, now we come to our second point, motion in a moving frame. Motion in a moving frame, I say that suppose a slab is moving and there is a person on the slab, and it is at the ground, someone is observing it. Maybe the ground is himself observing it. So here we'll be taking out the relative velocity with respect to the ground. VB plus VA is where VBG is relative velocity of B with respect to ground. With respect to ground. उसके रेस्पेक्ट में, ठीक है, ग्राउंड के रेस्पेक्ट में, तो VBG इज 3 + 5, 8 मीटर पर सेकेंड. प्लीज बी केयरफुल, व्हेन दे विल बी सेम डायरेक्शन, देन, सो व्हेन इट इज सेम डायरेक्शन, देन वी नीड टू डू माइनस. ओके, so it will be 5 minus 3, it will be 2 meter per second. So the relative velocity will be 2 meter per second. So I even said here that when it's same directions, velocity will be subtracted. When it will be different direction, opposite direction, the velocity will be added up. So here we'll be seeing that VBG is 2 meter per second. So here this will be seeing that this person is moving with 2 meter per second. Okay, 2 meter per second, done. Now comes the glass box. Okay, so the glass box, we have a person inside it which is moving upwards, okay, with 6 meter per second speed, and it is moving here with 8 meter per second speed. Okay, so what will be the relative velocity? So where now it has two axes. Okay, when it's one axis, then we'll be doing this simple algebraic summation, but now we have vectors. So here we have vector B and vector A, and this will be the resultant. So resultant will be A square plus B square plus 2AB cos theta. So the velocity will be 10 meter per second. Okay, now we have so the relative velocity of the body with respect to the ground is 10 meter per second. Now we have different problems of relative motion. The first is minimum distance or collision or overtaking problems. B is river boat problems. Another is aircraft wind problem, which is same as the relative as the river man problem, and the last one is the rain man problem. minimum distance or collision or overtaking problems. As in this problem, we need to take, as I said, that to make a problem easy, we just take two bodies and we see that one body is at rest and one body is in motion. When two bodies are in motion, the question like the minimum distance between them or the time when one body overtakes the other can be solved easily by the principle of relative motion. In these types of problems, one body is assumed to be at rest, and the types of problems one body is assumed to be at rest and the relative motion of the other body is considered. Okay, so by assuming this, the problem gets easier. Now we have a question. Car A and car B start moving simultaneously in the same direction along the line joining them. Car A moves with a constant velocity along the line joining them. Car A moves with a constant velocity 1 meter per second at time t equal to 0. The car A is 10 meter behind the car B. Okay, find the time when car A overtakes car B. So we took the velocity, the initial velocity of body A and the initial velocity of body B, which is moving. Okay, so by calculating it all, we get a relative velocity and the relative acceleration. Okay, we get a relative velocity and relative acceleration. Now in the problem, when we assume, so in a problem we assume that we take one body at rest. Okay, one body is moving, so we took out the relative acceleration, the relative velocity, and now we will be putting them all. The displacement will be 10 meter per second. Okay, so we'll be putting them all, and after putting we need to calculate the time. Okay, so by substituting the values, we got a quadratic equation, and here after calculation we got two values. One is in positive and one is in negative. Now we'll be simply ignoring the negative value and we'll be taking the positive value. So the time taken to overtake car A, okay, it is 2.5 seconds. Okay, 2.5 seconds it made him take. Now here we have another question, that a body is moving with 5 meter per second and the body is moving with 10 meter per second. Okay, and here the displacement is 20 meter and the acceleration is 2 meter per second. Okay, the displacement is 20 meter. Okay, so we'll be taking one body as an observer and one as moving. So here, after taking out the relative velocity and the relative acceleration, we got the values and we'll be putting them in the equation here, and then after equating it, we again get a quadratic equation and we get two values after doing the calculation. So we'll be taking the positive value. So to overtake, it took him 10.123 seconds. Okay, we'll be having a complete video on the problems of relative motion, but just to make you understand that we always need to calculate relative velocity, relative acceleration in the place we'll be taking in relative motion. We need to calculate these two and then we need to put them in the equation. So the second problem is, so in a river man problem, we have that we have a river. Okay, and here is a swimmer. So a swimmer need to swim and reach at this point. Okay, so when the river is at rest, okay, when the river is at rest, the velocity of the river is not moving, then he can simply swim and come to this point. But when there is a velocity of the water which is moving in river, then the swimmer will get drifted to this point. Okay, if water is at rest, then swimmer would reach at A point from B. When water is moving with velocity uf, then it will reach at point x, and this drift, he drifted, is the xd, the drifted displacement. Okay, velocity related to the water, xd is the drift due to the velocity of water. Okay, crossing the velocity of river is vs, the swimmer, the drift velocity is uf. Now the net velocity of the swimmer will be usg equal to us plus uf. Okay, sg, the ground. So swimmer's relative velocity with respect to ground is Vs this plus this, the vector form. Okay, the vector form. Don't ignore this. It is the vector form of vector Vs UF vector. Okay. Now we'll be taking out the components here. Vs have its component Vs sine theta and Vs cos theta. This is the theta. So when it's when the theta is in this, we take the base as cos theta and we take the perpendicular as sine theta. Okay, this is the drifted displacement and this is the point he need to come. Okay, so time to cross will be displacement by us, this velocity. Okay, and the xd, how will you be able to calculate this drift displacement? It will be uf minus vs sin theta. Okay, by the time taken. Here is the time, by the time taken. Okay, you need to understand that when when the body is, this is the swimmer, he need to come here. So I'm coming here, I'm swimming the river, okay, but the river has a velocity. So while I'll be covering this, he will push me like this. Okay, the velocity of the water will push me and I needed to reach here, but I'll reach here. I'll cross the river, but I'll drift. So this drift is xd and we'll be calculating this drift as uf, the velocity of the river, and the component of vs, okay, vs sin theta, and the time taken. So you understand now. If UF would be zero, then easily I would reach at my this point. But while I'll be moving, I'll be getting pushed by the velocity of the river. Okay, I'm like, suppose I'm moving like this. Okay, I'm simply moving like this. But the velocity of the river it's coming like this. Okay, so here I'm coming, the velocity of here, and I'm coming like this, so I will get opposed. Okay, and I needed to reach here, but I reached here. So this is the drifted displacement. I'll have a drift if there is a velocity of water in the river. Condition one is the shortest time interval to cross the river. Shortest time will be, there will be no drift. Okay, there will be no drift, and the component of Vs will be Vs cos theta. Okay, and this will be the displacement covered, the distance of the two points, and the shortest distance will be easily calculated, d by vs cos theta. And when it tries to move, when it tries to reach, then the velocity will be us. Okay, us, and r will be the distance. Okay, the displacement. And R will be the resultant. The resultant is D square, E square plus 2DE. Okay. Now, the drift velocity will be D. Okay, we took the vector. One vector is P. One is D. Now, this D is the drifted velocity. And this resultant, I say that you will be getting opposed. So, this will be the displacement. You understand? I wanted to reach here, I reached here. This will be my resultant. Okay, this is the resultant here. Okay, and this is the degree, this is the angle formed, alpha. Okay, when water was at rest, then the shortest time interval will be the perpendicular easily. And when it had velocity, then we need to take out the resultant. Okay. Now comes aircraft wind problems. This is same as Riverman problem. We'll be just replacing the values of the river boat, like when it is the river. This simply the value get moves, and it is just the same as Riverman problems. okay, you'll get a PDF and you can read it, the problems. And now I discuss the Rain Man problem. Okay, this problem is exactly same as River Man problem. Here we have a pilot who is moving in the air. So look, here we just need to calculate the alpha which is there. And okay, so this is similar to river boat problems. The only difference is that VRM is replaced by VAW, velocity of aircraft with respect to wind, VR replaced by VM, and VA replaced by VM. Further, VA is equal to VAW plus VW. In this case, problem is slightly different. Complete wind velocity is VW. These are the variables. Steering wind is VAW. Starting point is A, and the destination point is B. Here there is a slight change. Okay, this one. We used to write this, that in the Riverman problem we used to add, or like we need to do that. Now here we have VA equal to V, the relative velocity of A with respect to wind, plus VW. So we have to find direction of VAW, steering velocity, and the time taken in moving from A to B. The concept is net velocity of aircraft VA, or vector sum of VM and VAW, should be always along AB. To solve such problems, we can apply the following steps. Take starting point A as the origin. Wind velocity is completely given, so draw VW. We'll be seeing the steps. Wind velocity vector is completely given, so draw VW, and from the point A, draw another vector VA starting from A in the direction from A to B. In above two steps, we have already made two sides of a triangle in vector form. So look here, there is a question. I didn't write the question. So in this question, we will be giving the velocity, the wind velocity, okay, and the steering wind, and the starting point and the ending point. Okay, the starting point, the ending point, and here we need to calculate them all. So in above two steps, we have already made two sides of a triangle in vector form. Complete the third side. This represents VAW, this. Okay, while completing the triangle, for finding direction of AW, polygon law of vector addition, it is given in the vector lecture. You can go and understand it, then you can solve it here. I'll be basically discussing this whole problem with a problem, okay, in the video of my relative motion. Okay, so that VW plus VAW is VA, relative velocity of A with respect to wind. Applying sine law in this triangle, we can find the direction of VAW and the net velocity of aircraft VA. Okay, the time taken is AB by the magnitude of VA, or AB equal to VA. Okay, now comes Rain Man problems. So here we have the terms VR, VM, VRM. Okay, so here when we say that I'm walking here, okay, and there is rain, okay, the rain is happening, the rain is falling down, and rain has its velocity, and is my umbrella. So so the man should hold is the relative velocity of rain with respect to man. Here VRM is the velocity of rain which appears to the man. The man should hold his umbrella in the direction of VRM or VRM, so to save him from rain. Okay, like I'm walking, okay, and at what angle I need to keep my umbrella so that I won't get wet. Okay, here I am walking with a velocity VO. I'm the object, and here it is going. So first we'll be taking out the variable velocity, okay, and then we'll be continue. Like I take up a question here. A man is walking with 3 meters per second due to rain is falling vertically downwards with speed 4 meters per second. Find the direction in which man should hold his umbrella so that rain does not wet him. Okay, so vertically up, vertically down. So the velocity of rain, the rain is falling vertically downwards. Okay, V are equal to 4 meters per second, and this is the theta formed, and here the OP, okay, it is VR plus UM, okay, the man, this is the velocity of the man, okay, and we'll be taking out the relative velocity, okay. So by putting this, we get that here it is the, this is the base, this is the perpendicular, so tan theta is 3/4. By putting this tan inverse 3/4, we get the angle as 37 degrees. So look, this, okay, here was the angle formed. So this is the velocity of the man, this is of the rain, and you know the angle, the angle formed is, we take this as a base and this as the perpendicular, so perpendicular by base, and we got the angle. In this, we only, in this problem, we only need to take out the direction or the angle, okay, at what you need to protect. So these are the different problems of relative motion. So therefore the man should hold his umbrella at an angle of 37 degree east of vertical, or 37 from vertical downward. We need to take out the velocity, okay, the man is moving, okay, the man is moving here, V0, we can take it here too. So here we'll be first taking out the relative velocity, VR minus VO, okay, and then we'll be taking out the resultant. I always say that when it's a vector, then the resultant will be, the resultant will be the relative velocity, okay, the relative velocity, and by doing this we get a triangle, okay. So we can easily take out what is the base, what is the perpendicular, and we'll be getting, here's the formula, theta is equal to tan inverse of V, velocity of the object by velocity of the object by velocity of rain, and from here, as we took out here, 3/4, 37 degree. So these are basically the problems we get in relative motion or in the kinematics part, okay. So I'll be discussing the problems too in this of this problem, relative motion, and the next video will be coming either on the graphs and the derivation of the three formulas I given in the relative, in the kinematics, the three formulas, or it will be on the projectile motion. Okay, thanks for watching.